Have you ever participated in a lottery scheme where the process of picking the winner through a random sampling method is being broadcasted live? Would you be more confident in transparency of the system if some humans are choosing winners from handwritten names and numbers, or a computer generating random numbers? If you're like most people, you would pick computers as the right answer. After all, software doesn't cheat or lie. Or does it? To ruin your optimism, it does. At least the generative AI language models do, and do so very convincingly. It's really hard to tell. Not convinced? Try asking ChatGPT about a made-up company, let's say your name, Sewing Machine Enterprises, and ask it how it is doing against competition. Chances are you would be rewarded with a lengthy paragraph or more of text detailing company's struggle against mighty competitors. If chances of that happening are high, chances of you doubting that maybe the company with such name actually exists is even higher. Such is convincing nature of generated text, there is even a term for it, hallucinations. I will be spending some time going over the issue and its background before jumping to the pattern itself, because the issue is complex and has repercussions in real-world usage of large language models. Understanding it is really important. There is the famous example of Google Bard claiming James Webb Telescope taking pictures of exoplanets, where it's pretty harmless until you believe it and try to use the unverified output in real life. You may have heard famous cases where lawyers were fined for citing fake cases in court because they researched them using ChatGPT. Try giving it some complex mathematical or logical question from your school, and chances of it coming up with the wrong answer are pretty high. Fake statistics don't lag far behind. If you research for ChatGPT hallucinations on Google, most answers on top would be regarding fake references or citations being generated for research purposes. Don't take the wrong impression here. Large language models like ChatGPT or Bard are not deceitful evil villains trying to trick you with incorrect information. They are just models trying to come up with the most plausible output, given your input, based on the training data they work with. Additionally, they have generative AI capabilities built in, which in some contexts give you excellent results when trying to generate content like stories or works of fiction. But the same ability can bite you when you are using them in more sober settings. Interestingly, you can ask ChatGPT why it provides fake references and citations and give it a chance to defend itself. And one plea it would take is that the public internet, which acts as its training data, is riddled with fake references that seep in its responses, and model is unable to differentiate between credible and non-credible sources. Bottom line being that underlying all the sophistication where large language model is trying to generate a coherent, meaningful, probability-driven response to your query, it is a predictive model. The guesswork creeps in elsewhere where answers to mathematical questions are also guessed. Most people, being optimists, find it hard to double-check or fact-check everything that is provided to them. But sadly, when it comes to large language models, one is better off fact-checking everything. Specifically, if you intend to use the output in real life, like cite the research cases in court or add citations to your research paper. Chatbot operators are hard at work trying to minimize wrong answers, but the buck stops with you. Piecing together available information using probability to come up with the most plausible answer and generative AI are core features of large language models, and they would be worthless without this amazing capability. You can't take away the side effects of hallucination, though. Your options are to verify everything that it produces. In addition, since the video is about prompt patterns, which by definition are creative ways to solve common problems, there are ways to suppress or minimize, but not totally eliminate, or at least identify infactual or made-up material in ChatGPT responses. Right, enough background. Now I'm not going to leave you at the mercy of large language models here. The video is part of Prompt Engineering via Prompt Patterns video series, and it's time to introduce the fact check list pattern. The key is to leverage ability to instruct large language models to additionally generate a list of facts about the generated output. That should form an important part of the statements in the output. So the key statements used in the pattern are: generate a set of facts that are contained in the output. The set of facts should be inserted in a specific point in the output, let's say at the end. The set of facts should be fundamental facts that could undermine the veracity of the output if any of them are incorrect. How does this technique work? Well, the output text can be fairly large, and it might be difficult to properly go through each line and verify if it is accurate and factual. The list this pattern generates gives you a kind of shortcut to observe which assumptions and facts that have been used by large language models in the text. The list of facts allows you to understand how and why the generated output is produced this way, and also gauge whether the generated output missed some important consideration. That is the list of facts missing some important fact or consideration that should be there? One also needs to ensure that facts are good enough and ensure there isn't a weird statement there listed as a fact. Any mistake in list of facts would be a bloated problem in the generated text and would serve as a good red flag to follow up on. There is still hard work involved for you, and the pattern does not fix the inherent issue of hallucinations or ineffectual output. It, for one, jolts you out of disbelief that there can be errors in the generated output and kind of remind you that you have the responsibility to fact-check generated output. And secondly, you now have a fact list to begin the process of evaluation with. The bitter truth is that there is no guarantee of verifying accuracy of generated output even with this tool, but it is much better than evaluating generated output with no reference point at all. At least you can compare the output against the fact checklist to verify that output actually conforms to the list of facts. The pattern is particularly useful in the scenario where you don't have full domain knowledge in which the output is being generated. As an example, a software developer generating code might want to use this pattern to generate facts focused on security aspects. That can be done using scoping statements like only generate facts related to security. Taking another look at our earliest example of lottery algorithm, the factual statements might look like there should be no duplicates, numbers should be evenly distributed, etc., which would help you take another look at the generated numbers to not only ensure they conform to those facts, you can also come up with your own fact that say there should not be any skew in favor of odd versus even numbers or something, and instruct it as a fact to ChatGPT to incorporate. Here, let me go beyond this prompt pattern and discuss another technique to make response even more accurate. Do note that the model would always try to guess the output probabilistically, even if you are, say, asking it a logic-based maths problem. This would often result in incorrect answer. This would usually happen if there is computation or time required to come up with the answer, and model would try to respond in the shortest possible time and would resort to taking shortcuts. The remedy is to add additional statements or steps it must perform before responding to you. Here you kind of take control of the steps it must perform before it responds to you, so its ability to guess is bypassed by the steps you specify. The second technique, specially suited to logic-based math problems, is to explicitly instruct it to work out its own solution before responding. And in case of research, instructions like find relevant information and then answer based on relevant information really help model to perform extra computation before responding to you, and generally help reduce inaccurate or guess-based answers. In many cases, being explicit in instructing model to avoid generating incorrect output, like the technique we just covered, has shown remarkable improvement. Even instructions as simple as if you don't have information, just say I don't know, would dramatically reduce chances of made-up information being presented to you. Depending on situation to situation, you can instruct it accordingly to do due diligence, just like you would instruct some human apprentice who is learning to put some effort in to generate better quality work. This is it for the fact checklist pattern. You can check out other useful patterns like this in our playlist. Hope you liked the video, and if so, please like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching.